Mr. President. That's Ms. Crespi.
Yes.
Mr. Serra.
Thank you very much.
Oh, Mr. President, good to see you again.
Pleasure. Spanish ambassador. Minister's been extremely helpful, very supportive, and we've worked together very well, and we have a very good relationship with the Spanish Defense Minister.
The first visit that a Spanish Defense Minister has ever made to your country, we have to resolve that, to come more often.
That's right.
More often, yes.
We had a dinner in the Air and Space Museum last night, which was a very interesting place.
I'm really touched by the cordial reception of my friend, Captain
Byron. I enjoyed the visit of your Prime Minister and the visit of your King and Queen. We're sorry they were due to be here again and then that tragedy at the airport for that event.
Mr. President, we have a few minutes to sit down for that.
I'd like to go. In his last visit to the United States, he was appointed the Honoris Causa of Columbia University.
Yes.
And when he was in the United States, he had the accident in the Mendieta
Yes. We had first met them many years ago. That was 1972, when I was still governor of California. President Nixon had sent us on a mission, and we have the privilege.
Yes.
See you. Mr. Ambassador, you and I will go over to the fireplace for a photo.
Oh, thank
you. You will come in and join us after.
Thank you, sir.
And we'll exchange our credentials here.
Yes.
And why don't you ladies go?
Thank you, sir.
Well, welcome.
Very pleased to have you here.
Thank you so much, Joy.
Thank you for your stay.
Among lady or wife.
There you go.
Right.
The ambassador of Paraguay.
Yes, Mr. Ambassador.
Mr. President, well, it's a really honor and pleasure to be here.
I'm glad to have you here.
And Mrs.
My
Martinez
wife.
Mendieta.
You and I will go in front of the fireplace.
Right, right.
The photo.
Right.
And then you will join us.
Thank you, sir.
I know this is not new to you coming here, because you were married here.
That's right. That's right, Mr. President.
And I know you were also a good friend of our ambassador to Japan, Mike Mansfield.
That's right. That's right. I have a special message for him also.
Well,
that's right.
Won't you come and join us?
Master, could you step back just to, so I can take a picture of the children?
That is Geoffrey, Eunice, Elizabeth.
Hello there.
Gabriel. And Margaret.
Hello there.
And this is Mrs. Wabuge.
How do you do? I will go in front of the fireplace for a photo, and then you will all join us and we'll have one all together.
Thank you, sir.
Your Excellency, it gives me a great pleasure to present to you my credentials signed by my president, a political name to a great country. Well, we're pleased to have you here and the relationship that we have with your country. Thank you.
Now, good. You all come in.
Thank you so much. All right. Thank you very much.
It's good to have you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mr. Ambassador.
I did this at home.
Please have you here.
Mrs. Idriss.
Hello there.
And Mrs. Hello.
We appreciate very much the warm and personal attention that you gave to our delegation.
Circle the globe halfway by courtesy of my own government. The other one is a guest of your government, sir.
Yeah. You and I were over at the front of the fireplace and had a picture taken, and then you were all come in and join us in the family picture taken.
Thank you, sir.
We'll exchange our credentials.
Yes.
Well, we're very pleased to have you here. Won't you all come in?
Thank you. Oops, wait a minute. I could fly ship.
Will be very pleasant.
Can we do that, Chuck?
Yeah.
I resent that. Please, come behind me. Welcome to our country.
And that
one?
Touch it, can't you? Yes, and it's good to see you again.
Good to see you.
Pleased to have you here.
Yes, sir. I'm very pleased to present my credentials.
Well, I tell you, they would like to have us, right?
Will I have everything all here for you?
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Pleased to have you. A little more peaceful time.
Yes, very much more peaceful. I think so. Thank you very much. Appreciate it very much.
Mr. Ambassador,
it's a great privilege to meet you with you, sir. To all remember, I had the pleasure of being your guest in Sacramento when you was governor and I was second consul general in San Francisco.
Yes.
And I present my son, oldest Washingtonian of the family, has been in high school here for the last 3 years.
Oh, well, then this is
in anticipation of my coming.
Yeah. And you and I were here, and then
well, we think the last discussion that you remember too, and also gave me a very long talk before I came about the important respects to close relationship and have a good one.
All right, now we can.
This is just the letter of recall of my previous officer.
Thank you. Now, then we'll put you in the middle.
Thank you, sir.
Well, if you're entertained, please give her Mr. Guards, Prime Minister. It's a pleasure to welcome you.
Great privilege for me to be here, and I hope that I will try to get started with the country because we all like to.
And we can appreciate you and the
organization. So, can we move on to the future?
The Ambassador of Uruguay.
Yes.
Better be yourself. You're a pleasure. You're there now to be.
Well, this is the pleasure of having you. Yes, sir.
My wife. Senor.
Thank you.
To see
you. You and I will go over in front of the fireplace for a photo, and then you will join us for a photo.
It's a pleasure to tell you today. Here. Yeah.
to say to you and my God.
Well, it's a great pleasure to have you here. We appreciate the relationship we had with you.
Good friend of the United States.
Well, I know. We'll do our best.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. I have our papers.
Well, thank you. And
I'm looking at you. It's better than I see you. You're better.
Now, you can take your picture here in a minute.
Yes.
Well, welcome. Pleased to have you.
Bienvenido.
Good morning.
You're the hero. You came all the way back down here.
Well, I'm pleased to do it, Mr. President. When you call, here I am. Well, listen.
Hi,
Mr. President.
Sir,
how are you?
Nice to see you.
Good morning, sir.
How are you?
Good morning.
How are you?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm always glad to be with people from my.
Well, I appreciate that.
Excuse me.
Well, I know we're limited on time. Let me just say a word first. It's on the school prayer amendment. I know there's a difference of views and opinions on that. I've been concerned, hi, Faith.
Yes.
I've been
concerned,
as I've told some in talking to them, the whole image that's being portrayed, I think, is distorting this in people's minds. The image that somehow we're forcing prayer on the schools. I bet I've got more experience in grade school than anybody here because my old man moved around a lot. So I went to about a half a dozen schools before I got through eighth grade in different cities. And I remember in some, no one ever mentioned prayer. And I think it's all we're saying is that with protection built in, as I think is in 72, protection against someone being able to order or dictate a prayer. Protect against that was simply to make it plain that the Constitution says if people in a school want to pray, they should have the right to pray. And one of the reasons I feel so strong about it is it's not so much the fact of whether they do or don't pray actually in a school. It's what we're doing in saying to children that there is something questionable about prayer and therefore it can't be done in places like school. And I used the example once of these children, these kindergarten children down in the South, whose parents undoubtedly said grace at meals because in the cafeteria these little five-year-olds bowed their heads and were saying grace. And a federal judge of all things has ordered they can't do that. Well, now what happens when a five-year-old comes home and they start to say grace and he says, well, we're told at school you shouldn't do that. You can't do that. How do you explain to a five-year-old things of that kind and what has happened? So I would hope that we could find our way to say, no, the Constitution does not say that you can't pray in school. But let you all take over.
Mr. President, maybe I ought to say a word. I think all of us here, certainly the four of us in the Senate,